Hello, hello again. Bill Pfeiffer speaking from Marysville. Good to be with you. Remember the subscribe button and the like button if you like. I've been mentioning over the last week or two, or maybe almost month or so, there's an absolutely brilliant series on Prime TV entitled Chosen. The series shares selective parts of the Jesus's life, and most faithful to the scriptures, with some dialogue, costuming, and staging and acting. That's brilliant. No mushy, no maudlin, totally emotional kind of stuff, but really, really well, extremely well done. They've had about 150 million views so far, and the third season has been taped. I understand, however, in the third season, they got involved in the controversial thing of brothers and sisters of Jesus to show that he had conflict with his family. And I wish they would have avoided that. They really didn't need to do that. Brothers and sisters, I always have a hard time with that. The word that they use in the scriptures really means near relatives. It has nothing to do with brothers and sisters. John's gospel uses the word brothers. And the scripture scholars say it always refers to his apostles. And Jesus, I think he certainly would have, and Joseph would have certainly taken his brothers into Egypt, and at the foot of the cross, Jesus gave John the cure for his mother. I imagine why wouldn't he have mentioned his brothers, or where were his brothers during Jesus' passion and death and so on? But even beside all of that, the series is really good. It just shows so many really good things in the feeding of the poor, the 5,000. They put out a call for people for help, and not 5,000, but 12,000 showed up, and they had to provide their own transportation, food, and costuming, and so on, to show, again, just how popular the series is. One of the scenes depicts the most hated tax collector, Matthew, and Matthew's interest is piqued, is aroused by watching what Jesus is doing, and so he's becoming kind of more and more interested. And as Jesus is about to leave the village, he tells Matthew to follow him, and Peter gets a little upset over that. They're kind of new followers, and Peter's saying, you don't really understand, this guy's at least different. And Jesus response in the series to Peter is simply, get used to different. And boy, what a great line that is. I thought about it for weeks. Get used to different. You know, the gospel is different. Jesus' message is different. That's just over and over in my mind. There's just so many challenging things. And it just, at the top of the mountain, I think, of challenging sections of the scripture, the eight Beatitudes. Just listen to this. Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of God. Blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. Where do you find meek people these days, huh? Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, the right thing, the good thing, the true thing, for they shall be filled. Blessed are the merciful. Oh, mercy, huh? For they shall obtain mercy. Blessed are the pure of heart, for they shall see God. Marvelous thing, huh? Blessed are the peacemakers. Notice, not the peace lovers, but peacemakers. A lot of peace lovers around, dime a dozen. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called sons of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Boy, can you imagine if all of the leaders in the world, all of the countries, maybe even just at least all of the Christians in the world would make this a kind of a daily thing in their lives, the difference that would occur in the world. You know, we don't do any of that, huh? It's the words of G.K. Chesterton. If Christianity has failed, it's not so much that it has been tried and found wanting, but because it has never really been tried. And you know that's true. If people did this, the world would be different. You know, and at the top of the mountain, along with the Beatitudes, are the words of Paul in 1 Corinthians, love is patient, love is kind, love is not jealous. It does not put on airs, it is not snobbish, love is never rude, it is not self-seeking, It is not prone to anger, neither does it brood over injuries. Love never rejoices with what is wrong, but rejoices with the truth. There is no end to love's forbearance, to its trust, its hope, its power to endure. Oh, my goodness gracious, you know? Substitute your own name at the beginning of those words, and you begin to understand that get used to different is something that applies to your own life, you know? Bill is patient. Bill is kind. Bill is not jealous. Bill is never rude. You know, boy, what? Put your name in there and find out just how difficult it is to give your heart to Jesus and to the full gospel. Not an easy thing, but that's where life really is. So, you know, get used to different. But different is transforming. It changes you and it changes all of the people around you. When we're born, we're alienated from ourselves. And you can feel that. We're strangers in our own body, in our own psyche. You know, we're strangers to ourselves. We're strangers to others. We're strangers to God. We're strangers in the cosmos. And the gospel brings us back to not being strangers anymore, but to being lovers. So, you know, the happiness tomorrow always begins by doing the truth and getting used to different and the eight Beatitudes, not just the Ten Commandments, you know. You know, we in the West, we're interested in morality. The people in the East are interested in becoming more like God. That's where we should be. Happiness tomorrow, again, always begins by doing the truth today. Good to be with you. God bless.